Hey guys, this is Herschel Zahn with Renegade Art Productions and Gustavo Alfaro Photography. I am the official drone pilot for Gustavo Alfaro Photography, so when Rogue Photo hooked us up with this wonderful drone landing pad from flathatlabs.com, we were really excited because a drone landing pad can be very useful in a lot of situations. Initially, I was impressed with the build quality of this product. Normally, when you get a pop-up or some type of an expandable product like this, the materials can sometimes not be of that high quality. This is an exception. The bag itself is usually the first thing to go on one of these products, and the zipper, the first part of that bag to go. Both of these are high quality materials, great nylon, strong zipper. It's gonna last you coming in and out of a kit bag for a long, long time. One of our landings, we had a slight tip over, which caused the props to rub against the nylon of the landing pad for a couple of seconds. And I was very impressed to see that it just scratched it. It could have cut it, shredded it. If it was not quality materials, it would have, but this is going to be a product that is going to last you for a long time. At 32 inches, it's just about the perfect circumference for a small drone like the Phantom 4 Pro here, or a Mavic, any of the Autel products, any of the unique products. They're gonna be really great for that. On the website, it does talk about landing an Inspire 1 or an Inspire 2 on this pad. I would have a hard time thinking that you would be able to get all four landing struts on that pad unless you're a really, really precise pilot. So I would probably go with a larger landing pad for something of that size. Now, some people may be asking, why would I need a drone pad to begin with? Why do I need a launching pad? I can just sit it on the ground and it will take off. Yes, you can do that, and that's the miracle of a system like the Inspire or the Phantom. It does allow you to take off and land just about anywhere. However, there are a few reasons why you might want to invest in something like a landing pad. The first is when you're taking off in, say, a gravel or a sandy area or even grass that has a lot of dirt, it's going to kick up a lot of debris when the aircraft takes off. Another reason you may want to invest in something like a landing pad is just simply for looks. If you're like me and you do a lot of real estate or in and out a lot of places and you're trying to hide from the drone because you don't want to be in your video, sometimes you're having to hide under cars, under trees, around corners, around buildings. You can end up looking a little shady. So anything that I can personally do to improve my professional image, I like to do. For instance, I wear a yellow safety vest whenever I'm flying on a real estate job. So by putting out a landing pad, that kind of projects that I'm here professionally, I'm supposed to be here, everything's okay. So let's take a look at a couple of examples of the drone taking off and landing using the flat hat pad. First was outside of our real estate location. We did launch from the street. It was able to take off very quickly and land very quickly. The nice thing about something like this on a street is it's going to allow you some contrast when you're using your precise return to home points. The drone will actually take off, fly up 20 feet, and take a visual picture of what's going on. So having something there with contrast is helpful. Deploying the pad in the middle of the street, we were able to actually take off smoothly, and it was able to use the automatic features, and it would land on the pad almost every time. The second and most dramatic example, we stopped off in a gravel parking lot, and you can see that the drone without the pad kicks up a lot of dirt, a lot of dust, a lot of debris. However, when we deploy the pad, I expected it to minimize it, but it cut it out almost completely. So that was extremely impressive to me at how valuable something like this landing pad can be. The third example is the one I've struggled with the most because I do end up taking off in a lot of grassy areas. Grass can present a lot of problems for a drone. Namely, it can bind up the gimbal and not allow the gimbal to move very well. You'd never want that, so you have to hold the drone up, which can affect the compass if it's floating around in the middle of the air. So having something like the pad to sit on the grass, to allow free range of movement for the gimbal is very important. And as we also discussed, any debris is not gonna get kicked up into the rotors or the gimbal mechanism. The price point on the landing pad is really great. You can get it for $39.95. The lighting kit comes for $17.95, allowing you to get this whole setup for under $60. I've seen drone landing pads upwards of $100. Overall, I could not be more impressed with this landing pad from Flat Hat Labs. Whether you're a professional or an amateur or a noob, this is going to be something that's going to add value to your kit and help you protect your equipment, which is the most important thing. Thank you so much for joining me. I am Herschel Zahn with Renegade Art Productions and Gustavo Alfaro Photography. Special thanks to Rogue Photo for hooking us up with this product, and we will catch you in the next one.